Good morning students, this is your geography lesson. Students, as you know that we are reading about export processing zones in Pakistan. Today we will read more about export processing zones. So we start our lesson. You are supposed to open page number 195 and read and understand about the importance of EPZs in Pakistan. The potential of establishing EPZs on the Makran coast. It is an established fact that sea transportation is the cheapest mode of transportation in the world. You know very well that sea routes are very important for trade point of view, and these ways and routes are the cheapest mode of transportation for a country. It is a competitive world, and a producer or a manufacturer has to be cost conscious, as the world is like a global village, and the competition in every sector is very fast, and everyone who is investing something on a place, he or she is very conscious about the cost. A foreign investor will obviously feel more comfortable in setting up an industrial unit at or near a seaport. So, if a businessman or industrialist who is going to invest something or build an industry, he will definitely look at the area. And the area and the unit near a seaport is very beneficial for the investors. Moreover, the arrival and dispatch of goods between two countries can be organized better at a port city rather than at an inland city. Similarly, the goods and the productions materials can be carried out and carried out or taken into the country is easier rather than inland or air routes. So Makran coast is very important as we look at establishing EPZs. Strategic geographical situation of Gwadar. Gwadar's location between Karachi and UAE via the Sultanate of Oman and Iran on the one hand, and on the doorstep of the Central Asian states case on the other, could be suitable for EPZs due to a number of factors. And other important sea port is Gwadar, that has a very much that has much importance as geographical point of view for Pakistan, because it links between Asian countries as well as Middle East countries. And what are the factors that contribute a lot for the establishment of EPZs? Number one, foreign investment. Foreign investment along with high tech for EPZs could be attracted to Gwadar and Ormara, being port cities with access and exposure to the case. So foreign investment point of view, the seaport of Gwadar is very important, as Pakistan can attract the attention of different industrialists to establish industries here in this region. Number two, the port of Gwadar can serve as a regional trade hub with the recent geopolitical developments in the region, such as rehabilitation and development of Afghanistan and the case. So, the port of Gwadar can be a regional trade hub as it can attract the attention of international businessmen and industrialists to develop their business in this region. The port of Gwadar, when developed, will be in a position to cater for the requirements of the trade, the UAE, Oman, Saudi Arabia and Qatar, besides serving as a gateway to the landlocked countries of Central Asia. Landlocked countries are those countries that don't have any seaport, as Afghanistan doesn't have any seaport. So Afghanistan does trade with the link of this seaport. Similarly, central countries of Central Asia. This will help in the marketing of EPZ's products, as these countries are linked together through this seaport. The establishment of export processing zone will help to publish, to market, to advertise the products, the local products and domestic products of Pakistan. Number three, the deep water port and export processing zone can be developed simultaneously. An area covering 100 hectares of land has already been allocated for the establishment of an EPZ, while another 4,000 hectares have been reserved for an industrial zone. So this port is very much important for economic point of view, as 100 hectare of land has been allocated for the establishment of EPZ. Similarly, four thousand hectare have been reserved for an industrial zone, so that Pakistan's economic industry will be developed in this form. Number four, infrastructure facilities such as transport links, water sources from Desht River and the Mirani Dam, desalination plants and power generation through Wapda plant at Pasni could be arranged by the government. These facilities are required for the development of EPZs. So these are the factors and these are the objectives for the development of EPZs. If government is going to develop EPZ on the seaport, infrastructure facilities are also required, as transport links, water resources and desalination plants and Wapda plants also required to establish in this zone. Functions of the Export Promotion Bureau. The Export Promotion Bureau was formed by the Government of Pakistan for organizing and regulating export activities. Its functions include creating awareness among the manufacturing service sector about potential exports. First objective of the organization was, of the bureau was, to create the awareness among the manufacturing service sector that how much potential our exports are having. Number two, exploring and identify market opportunities abroad. another function of this bureau is to explore market opportunities on international level, so that we can do trade with other countries in international market as well. Number three, assisting Pakistan's entrepreneurs to secure entries in the international market. And other function of this bureau is to assist Pakistan's entrepreneurs to help them to find out international market trade, to find out new business, new development in international market. Restrictions on imports. The balance of payments can also be corrected by decreasing imports. Students, we can correct the balance of payments by cut down our imports. At present, consumer goods accounts for 14% of the total import bill. Most of the consumer goods are just luxury items, and some could easily be manufactured in Pakistan. So as we know that we are very much concerned about the luxury items, luxury goods. We are very much aware of the brands. So we are spending a lot of amount on our luxury items. We can cut down our imports by manufacturing these goods and items in our own local industries. The reduction in import of consumer goods and industrial raw materials can greatly reduce the deficit gap. In this way, if we cut down the imports of luxury items and luxury goods, moreover raw materials, we can automatically be able to achieve the target of the balance of payment. Reduction in imports related to the tertiary sector. The tertiary sector includes banking, insurance, education and health. So these are four sectors and four parts of tertiary sector. In Pakistan, a trend has been set to hire skilled personals from other countries on high salaries. In Pakistan, we see and we observe that we usually hire qualified and skilled persons on high salaries. The demand of salary is on high level, on high scale. This is an extra burden on the foreign exchange resources. If the industries, if the companies pay a heavy amount, heavy salaries, this is extra burden on our foreign exchange resources. The solution lies in training our own people according to the standards required by companies and institutions operating in the tertiary sector. So the time is to train our own local labor, local force, local people, so that we can be self-sufficient, self-dependent, and we can earn our own money by producing things and by earning things, by earning money as the form of foreign exchange. So students, this is our lesson for today. I hope you have understand a lot from this lesson. You have to read it again for better understanding. Thank you for listening. Take care. Allah Hafiz.